Before we get to any questions, I think the Board of Supervisors, what we would like to do is thank the volunteer fire companies that actually responded yesterday. There were over 100 firemen, I believe, that were here. There were probably 20 to 30 fire companies that were here to help us. And they were here for the majority of the day. And yesterday was being the hottest day of the year. We have to really commend them, and we're very fortunate to have the volunteer fire companies in Westmoreland County that we have. I would also like to thank our employees who actually came out yesterday, who helped us in any way that they could, and they did it on their own time. Also would like to talk about the outpouring of support that we've been getting today from our fellow supervisors and fellow municipalities who want to offer us equipment, who want to give us manpower. So in Westmoreland County, as well as Fayette County, parts of Allegheny, there are people that are coming out of the woodwork to help us. So we are very fortunate. Right now, we have been talking to our insurance carrier to see how fast we can move on replacing equipment, because we lost half of our equipment. So we're doing so. We're looking for a temporary maintenance garage at this time, so we can continue to do the work that we've been doing. What I will tell you is that our motto right now is to continue and do the work that we have been doing. And we're going to do it. We're going to do that. And all we need to do is make sure that we have the equipment to actually do just that. And we will be doing so. And at this, I don't know if my colleagues have anything else to say, but please.
I'd like to thank everybody. I'd like to say, but it is business as usual. We will maintain and do what we have to do. And even with the equipment that we lost, we did save half. And if we need any equipment, with all the other everybody offering equipment, not just municipalities, everybody, we got inundated with phone calls. So it's not like we can't do a job because we do not have a piece of equipment. We will borrow it. But it's going to be business as usual, and we're going to do what we need to do to keep things going forward.
Really don't have much to add. John and Mike covered everything. Again, though, I would like to thank the firemen. They did an excellent job. The right hand knew what the left hand was about to do. They were superior.
Are there any questions that you have of the Board of Supervisors at this time? Well, actually, the insurance adjusters have been in. That is something that we're working on right now. We're actually working on, what money may be available as soon as possible to replace a lot of the maintenance things that we need to be able to do our job, such as equipment to put up a stop sign. It's as simple as that. We lost a lot of the equipment, many hand tools, welders, as well as bigger pieces of equipment. And these are things that we need to replace as soon as possible. And actually, right now, our eye is on the winter. So we're trying to actually make sure that we have everything in place so when we get into winter, we never know when it's going to snow. It could be around Halloween. So we want to be ready to perform snow removal. And that's what we do. And Unity Township does it quite well. And Unity Township will continue to do it that way this year also.
As of right now, does it look like you will be ready to go for the winter?
Absolutely. We may not have the newest equipment yet, because it takes time to get new equipment, but we will have equipment. And one of the reasons we will is because of our fellow and neighboring municipalities. They have reached out. If we wanted to right now, we could probably have 40-some trucks. We just don't have enough people to drive 40-some trucks right now. But that's fantastic that they're reaching out to us. That just goes to show you what kind of people live in Western Pennsylvania and Pennsylvania in general.
Can you talk about some of the people that went into the building yesterday when it was on fire to get some of the equipment out?
Yes, there were two. Mr. John Milan and a gentleman that's sitting in the back, Scott Morrison. They were first on the scene. They actually went in and they actually saved half of our trucks. And there was also adjacent to the building some equipment that was sitting there, and they were able to grab it. By the time I got there, gentlemen, they actually got the last vehicle out, or the last truck out, and that is really when the building started to pop.
There was another fellow, Danny Bald. He's a Youngstown fireman. He was one of the first ones on the scene too. He warned us not to go in there, but needless to say, I don't listen half the time. So we did our thing. But Danny Bald did come in. He did come in with us, and he did drive a few of the trucks out. Because it was like one of them movies on TV. You went in there, you couldn't see. It was just dark, and it was just you. That's the thing. You jumped in a truck and kept looking for the door, the light at the end of the door to get them out. But thank God for Danny. Thank God for Scotty Morrison. And just thank God it worked out, so we did get to save some of our equipment.
And just on that note, since we're one of the people that went in there, what made you do that? I mean, that's kind of a
You get in a situation like that, and your adrenaline goes, and the first thing I thought when I came in, holy smokes, you don't know what to say, but I'm thinking, this, your heart's into it. Your heart's into the township. You know, this is our township. We can't lose everything we work for and have. We can't. So what I did, was it wrong? Yeah, I probably shouldn't have, but it all worked out for the better. But I mean, sometimes your adrenaline goes and you just don't think. I guess that was one of them incidents, and God was with us.
John, do you remember how many trucks you were able to get up, just yourself?
I think between all of us, I think we basically three apiece, and we had vans and something like that. But the time frame all worked out, because once they got out, there was nothing that you couldn't get back in.
And they had to work rather quickly, because by the time I got here, John maybe beat me by maybe 7 minutes or so. The flames were more or less in front of the building. And by the time I got around back, those flames had engulfed the whole building. So actually, John and Scott and Mr. Bald, they got out in a nick of time. They really and truly did. And thank God that he's here to talk about it today.
Who first alerted you to the fire, or called it in?
Well, our alarm company went off. And actually, what they do is they call us. But also, and I'll let John talk about this, because he got a phone call from someone who was walking on our walking path adjacent to the lake.
Yeah, there's a resident that comes and does his laps on the lake there, and he called, and first I thought he was joking. I was hoping he was joking, and I just hung up the phone. I'm saying, I'm getting right there. He said, your building's on fire, the garage is on fire, the garage is on fire. And with that being said, just beelined it straight here, and I called Mike on the way.
Any other questions?
Mike, you don't have a fire hydrant up there. If you redo that building up there, what do you guys put in fire?
Yeah, we will try to do that. The public water was run. Or actually was ran, I believe, in 2004, 2005, after the building was already put up. But one of the things that we knew we always had was the lake, and it was utilized pretty well yesterday for water. Pete, and if you'd like to talk about that,
We were dealing with two water systems, and Latrobe Domestic. We were dealing with two water systems, the Latrobe Municipal Authority, also in the Westmoreland Municipal Authority. There is a connect from the Westmoreland Authority at the far end of Fry Farm Road here. There's a valve there in case there's a water loss in some of the Latrobe area that they can turn on to supply water into that system. So originally they were working off of the Latrobe system, and then that valve was open for us, and they got the sufficient pressure they needed to operate their equipment.
Is there anything that leads you to believe that this might be suspicious?
I actually cannot answer that at this time, Mr. Tenorovich.
The investigation is going on right now. The fire marshal is here. As soon as we get his results, we'll let you know.
I know that you have mentioned, because of the generosity of your neighbors here, that you'll be able to have all the equipment that you'll need. But is there any sort of specialty equipment that's going to take a little longer to replace?
Well, just to put everything in proper perspective, to replace a truck with a brand new one, it takes anywhere from 6 to 9 months to actually have it built for what you need it to do. Whether it's four-wheel drive, whether it's a single axle, these are things that we would like to do, or we would like to replace the trucks that we had, because they were special. We bought them because we have a lot of hills in the township, and a lot of these trucks took care of those hills. Great-alls. We lost two great-alls. We lost a sweeper. We lost a mower. All those things take time to get in. Those pieces are not as specialized as the trucks, so we could probably get those in anywhere from 5 or 6 months, depending if they're being built right now at the manufacturer. But with that said, in the wintertime, we're not going to utilize great-alls as much. We're coming up to the season where we utilize trucks more. But as John had talked about business as usual, we still have some paving left. We have a paver. We have actually two pavers that are intact. We have some trucks. We are going to get trucks to help us, load pavers, and we're going to finish the work and try to finish the work that actually we started.
Did the building have a fire suppression system?
No.
Was that built then before?
That was prior, yes.
Okay, before. Okay. And you guys did not, obviously then, did not put it in?
No. Okay. No.
Too.
Yeah.
Simple. Some of the simple things in life, just like we had no hand tools. We lost all our tools. Our guys up there, they're the welders. We lost everything because anything we need. That's one thing. We do a lot of in-house. That's what saves the taxpayers a lot of money, is the in-house work. It gets done up at the garage. We don't have anything. We lost all that. Welders, tools. So if something's broke or needs repaired, instead of shipping it out and spending your money on something down the road, we got to get all that back too. So some of the simple things in life hurt you the most, but we don't have no tools. We didn't even have a stop sign to put up, because you never know when someone runs over a stop sign and we get called out to replace it. So we got all that. We borrowed that from other municipalities. We got stop signs and starter posts, but there's a lot. I mean, it's just not just the trucks. It's everything we had in the shop there, everything, all our tools, they're gone. So we will have to get back on track and rebuild and get what we need.
And again, how many trucks was it that you all lost?
Seven. We lost seven big ones. We lost one ton. We lost the utility van. We lost the Ford. We lost the Ford Ranger.
Yeah, the little Ford truck.
And all the
tools. Yes, and two great alls, and the mower, and the sweeper.
Now, as it is right now, if we have a breakdown on the vehicles that we were able to save, we have to have tools to be able to fix these. these trucks and also the equipment that we do have that was untouched by the fire. So, you know, we're in the process of doing so. And as John says, sometimes it's the little things, the simple things that you need the most. Well, in this case, it is. But as we had said before, the municipalities around us are reaching out and basically trying to give us anything that we may need. Now, we did set up a meeting with our our Westmoreland County Supervisors Association. They're coming today at 4:30, and they're bringing lists of equipment that they may have. And we're in the process right now of getting our equipment needs together. So when we ask our fellow supervisors and mayors and commissioners what they may have, they will be able to tell us right away. But I think, you know, a lot of times when you have a tragedy, people come together. And they really do the very best that they can to help you. But I just want you to know that municipalities have been working together for years, and we're always out to help each other. And we just don't do these things when there's a fire or an emergency. We do that on an everyday basis. So I think that our municipalities in this area really work well with each other.
Do you expect any kind of impacts to taxpayers?
No, not at all. Not at all. We were completely insured. Now, you know, granted, you can't replace everything at the current values, but most of the equipment that that we lost, it was fairly brand new. So the values of that equipment are pretty high. Yes.
Is there a lot of stuff that's specialized as well?
No, yes.
Tools, things like that.
I think you're hitting on it right well, actually. And we had talked to our insurance carrier this morning, as I had said before, to see, you know, what kind of money can be freed up right away to buy these incidental tools that we need right away. And he's on it. We probably by the end of the week, we will know what we can buy right now. Pardon me?
Vehicle lists or anything along those lines
that were
lost?
We do have lists. Yes, and John actually pretty much mentioned everything that we have lost, other than the contents that were inside the garage, which we do have an inventory on, and all those smaller items were all insured. But as John said, we lost six big trucks. We lost a Ranger, we lost a one ton, we lost two Great Alls, we lost a street sweeper, we lost a broom truck. So these were all things that we utilized on a daily basis.
Forklift.
And a forklift also. How can I forget about that?
We're on Showcase, so three of the walls are unstable. Are you planning to tear them down, the building down soon?
We're gonna go on the advice of structural specialists that are coming in right now to look at what we're at and, you know, what's the best way to handle that. They will work in conjunction with the fire marshal that's up there now. Three out of the four walls right now are pretty shaky.
Pretty shaky?
Pretty shaky. They look pretty shaky, yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Are you looking to rebuild that site?
Well, I believe so. My term ends at the end of the year, so my recommendation is to build on that site. If there is any silver lining out of the fire, you know, when we do rebuild, you know, maybe we can reconfigure some things and maybe do some things different. So I imagine you may have some new people who will be able to give some great ideas on that.
If it would cost more than $1 million to build back in 2004?
About $1.8 million.
Oh, that's
Yeah, it was right around there. To rebuild that garage as it is today would cost a maybe double the price. Yeah, maybe. And I'm not an engineer, so I don't know how well that, you know, that estimate is. But you know, when we moved into the township garage, after, because we were in three different satellite facilities at the time, and most of them didn't even have heat, so we felt like we moved into the Taj Mahal. And when you saw it on fire yesterday, you know, you thought about the times when it was 10 below zero and you're in one of these satellite garages and there's no heat. So, you know, we were very fortunate that we had the building that we did. But we will rebuild it. But I think what we want to make sure is that the residents of our township know that we are there for them right now. One of our jobs is to perform public safety, and we will be ready when the snow flies. I won't be in a truck anymore, but John will. Anything else? Well, you know, we'd like to thank you for coming out today. And getting the message out, and I'm sure that you will. But the bottom line is there are some great people out there who are willing to help us. Thank you.